Mr. West is in the building, swagger on 100,000 trillion. Ayo, I know I got it first, I'm Christopher Columbus, y'all just the pilgrims. Thanksgiving, do we even got a question? Hermes pastel, I pass the dress.
Thanks for tuning in with me to this week's TBEAS talk show. I am so excited because each week I'm out there getting highlights on our middle school sports so that they can showcase their talent to those out there who want to see it. This week we have some funny and entertaining news for you, so you don't want to miss our pro spotlight. And as promised, we're here to get you the best highlights on local sports. So let's get it. Again, you guys, my favorite part of the show, word of the daytime. So we have two words for you that we want you to throw in your vocabulary vault. Our first word is actuate, and it means to put into action or to influence to act. So basically what that means is if you have something stirring up inside of you, something that's positive, something that you want to let out and put out into the world, you have to actuate in order for some things to happen. That means you have to put it into action. Let's actuate by actually doing and not just saying. And so our second word that I give you is agglutinate, and it means to stick together, join together. And in light of Black History Month, we must learn to agglutinate if we want to get somewhere, if we want to go far, if we want to make things work. We want others to hear our voice, and if we don't agglutinate, we're not going to get anywhere. So let's stick together, you all. Let's join together and make some things happen. So again, student athletes, when I give you these words, don't hold it in. Share it with others. Pass it along to others. If you have friends, little brothers or sisters, don't be afraid to go up and hold a conversation with them using that word in a sentence. Knowledge is power, but we want you to be able to learn how to hold a conversation with anyone and feel confident about it.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. They can say whatever, I'ma do whatever. No pain is forever, yep, you know this. Tougher than a lion, ain't no need in trying. I live with a sky in, yep, you know this. Never lying, truth teller. That Rihanna rain just won't let up. All black on, blacked out shades, blacked out Maybach. I'ma rock this shit like fashion, as in going till they say stop. And my runway never looked so clear, but the hottest bitches in heels right here. No fear.
And in our college spotlight, according to SB Nation, the number one UConn slaughters USC, takes advantage of Gamecocks' lapses. Right out of the gate, the Huskies jumped on the Gamecocks and didn't let up. Hearing the names UConn and South Carolina naturally can strike fear in all of their NCAA opponents. So when these two names are in the same conversation, the basketball world stops as they disrupt the peace. Thursday night, the Gamecocks and the Huskies went to work on the hardwood as the two teams took a small break from conference play for the highly anticipated matchup. However, not afraid of the spotlight, the number one UConn Huskies stormed past South Carolina as they continue to remain untouchable, extending its record to 21-0, making them one of the two teams still undefeated in Division I sports. The Huskies led the entire game and defeated the number 7 South Carolina Gamecocks in an 83-58 win. I know for sure it feels good to the head coach Gino Aurimo to be back in that seat of being number 1 and not losing any games. Just reminiscent of what happened last year when they had an upset where they were defeated for the first time and ever breaking a 100-game winning streak. I know it tore those players apart to lose a game, but this year they're back on top again, proving them to be the number one UConn Huskies.
Yeah.
Great news that we delivered today with our WNBA, their trades and their new picks, and then of course with the newest Philadelphia Eagles winning our Super Bowl championship. Our question of today is, what are the qualities that create a championship team? I tell you right now, there are a few qualities that matter most to me. You definitely need to be fundamentally sound. You also need to have the desire to play. And also, you gotta put in the time. It takes a special set of athletes, a special type of desire, and a work ethic that is second to none, and a coaching staff that would rather devote their time and energy to the team above and beyond anything else. Even with the intangibles, there is never a guarantee that any team with these five main attributes will be championship quality. But if a team thinks like a champion, works like a champion, and is coached and acts like champions, they will be champions, even if they finish in last place. Comment your answer below. Last night, Philadelphia Eagles quarterback Nick Foles delivered one of the most spectacular Super Bowl performances of all time. And he did it while facing the NFL's version of Goliath, the New England Patriots. Foles wasn't even supposed to be in this position. He took over as the Eagles' default quarterback after Eagles' starting quarterback, Carson Wentz, went down less than 2 months ago with a torn ACL. After a couple of good games and a couple of mediocre ones, he proceeded not only to lead his team to the Super Bowl, but to outduel arguably the greatest quarterback of all time in the process. He basically talks about leadership. And in this interview, he could have told us how he knew all along he would make it here. He could have told us how he deserved to be on the stage and that he never lost belief in himself. Instead, Foles reminded us that as recently as a couple of years ago, he almost gave up on football. But as he shared his struggle, he was the picture of calm and collected. And it was an image he projected throughout the previous few hours, from warm-ups to his outstanding performance. Foles then gave a major lesson in leadership, brilliantly captured in a few short words. And basically, I brought this moment up to just express true leadership is about action. It's putting your head down, going to work, and trying to lift up those around you. Despite putting on a performance for the old, for the ages, Foles recognized that football is a team game. And sure, a lot of his plays helped propel them forward in winning the Super Bowl championship, but he also expressed that it was a team effort. There is no Super Bowl win without the perfection of his front line. There's no Super Bowl win without the amazing play calling of Eagles head coach Doug Peterson. There is no Super Bowl win without the defense that forced Tom Brady to fumble in crunch time. So Foles recognized all of this. He knew that great teams aren't only about who's on your team, but about how the team works together. By showing humility, setting the example, and praising his teammates, Foles demonstrated emotional intelligence. This man could have surely took this platform to brag about, oh, I knew I was going to make it here. I never doubted myself. They might have doubted me, and I'm glad that I got the chance to show everybody what I can do. He didn't do that. He took this time to express leadership. Congratulations to Nick Foles and the Philadelphia Eagles.
Thank you.
And in professional news, it says the Eagles won the Super Bowl for the first time in franchise history on Sunday night. Philadelphia knocked off New England 41-33. Of course, the city of Philadelphia went crazy in celebration. Thousands of green and white fans took the streets to go wild. I mean, how far can a city take it when they win the Super Bowl? Well, it says here, according to thescore.com, that Eagles fans stormed streets, wrecked Philadelphia after the Super Bowl win. I mean, I get it, guys. I understand that this is a big win for your city. It's going to bring in more money. I mean, it means a lot when you win something as big as a Super Bowl. So basically, these guys took that win and wanted to run with it. And not only did they run, but they ran over the city. You don't have to wreck the city and act as if like it's a riot going on. I get it, the Super Bowl is big, but I mean, how far is big? Well, it says here that this fan decided to get on two knees and scoop some poop with his mouth. And I'm not making that up. I want y'all to see this for yourself. Exactly. I mean, I can't even fathom the thought of something like that that could encourage anyone in their heart to get on two knees and scoop up what I would like to think of as the end of the parade horse. Yeah, this joker actually got down on two knees and ate it, y'all. And I mean, I just think that was quite disgusting. I can almost accept that the town wanted to tear down some light poles, jump over some cars, topple some cars over. I even accepted the fact that little old teapot Kevin Hart wanted to get out there on the field after the win and just do his thing. Be better than that. Be better than eating horse poop off the ground, Philly man. Come on, man. He gonna regret that when it's time to have Netflix and chill with his little old lady. Moving along to our WNBA, according to SB Nation, we have some interesting trades, some expected re-signings in day two of free agency. And it says here, today was once again busy in the WNBA as more players inked new contracts. Phoenix was extremely active as they traded not only Kayla George to Connecticut, but also sent Kinsley Bone to Las Vegas as the Mercury picked up a couple draft picks. Dallas decided to sign Teresa Placens to a multi-year contract. However, it is circulating online if she will return in time for the season as she tore her ACL in October while playing overseas. Yesterday, it was rumored Jessica Braylon was going to be signing with Atlanta, yet no release has been published. According to the WNBA's transaction page, Braylon has in fact signed with the Dream after playing with the Chicago Sky since 2014. Courtney Paris will no longer suit up with the Dallas Wings as today she signed a multi-year contract with the Seattle Storm. And talk about the Dallas Wings, this is huge in the WNBA news. Liz Cambage officially signs with Dallas. One of the best basketball players in the world, Liz Cambage, has returned to the WNBA and has signed her multi-year contract with the Dallas Wings. Liz is a triple threat player who can shoot, pass, and defend inside the paint extremely well, said Wings head coach Fred Williams. She will provide a strong inside-out threat that I think will be very exciting for our fans in the league. She's also a great addition to the culture we've built in the last few years in Dallas. So it looks like they snagged a good one this year. Congratulations to the Dallas Wings on that one. And in light of Black History Month, this week's Name That Movie goes to a 2000 American sports film. It's a biography of a true story of a newly appointed African-American coach and his high school team on their first season as a racially integrated unit. So of course it's about football. Our first clue is basically a part that's in the movie. So let me get into roll. I'm Louis Lastic. I'm an offensive lineman. Native family just moved here from Bayonne. Someone said football, so I come running. What's going on, everybody? Another part that was in the movie. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Hey, hey, hey. Goodbye. White clouds, sunshine. So if you think you know the name of this movie, make sure you comment below. And in light of Black History Month, I would also like to give you an inspirational quote given by, she was born Sarah Breedlove. She was an African-American entrepreneur, a philanthropist, and a political and social activist. But she went by another alias. And that quote is, don't sit down and wait for opportunities to come. Get up and make them. You can't just sit back and wait for the opportunities to come to you, because sometimes they're not. You have to get out and put the work in. You can't be lazy. You can't expect that people are going to always help you, that things are going to come easy, that people are going to always be there for you. Sometimes you may even look up and realize or feel that you're doing it all by yourself. But it's okay, because that means you're trying to get out there and make some things happen. Now, because it's the first Friday in the month, if you can guess who I'm talking about, comment below and you can get a free gift certificate to a restaurant. So who wouldn't want to go out to eat and not have to pay for it, right? So yes, just comment below who I'm talking about. Thank you all so much for tuning into this week's show. Like I told you, it's going to keep getting better and better. I hope you enjoyed our content and what we have for you. As promised, we're here to get you the best highlights on local sports in our community. Stick with me each week. We're going to be right back here the same time every Friday, 8 p.m.-ish. And I leave you with this from my wall that talks. Just remember, guard over everything. Period, point blank. And then I also leave you with this. Prayer still works. And I actually find that to be very true.